moves have been missed.
She fell flat on my face. It was pure embarrassing.
Physics have been broken.
What the fuck happened there?
Laws of time and space shattered in an instant.
The legs!
Yes, this is entertainment, but the glitches are real. Whoever you are, whatever you do, please don't play this at home.
Hello, sexy friends. My name's Adam. I run Super Pro Wrestle, I run this account, and I run Wrestling Without Context. Now, there's been a lot of talking about morals in wrestling lately. Should a wrestling company book this guy who's done these horrible, horrible things? Should a wrestling company run in this country where people are discriminated against? Now, I just want to say, everyone's welcome at Super Pro Wrestle. Apart from bigots and that, obviously. And I just want to let you all know it'll be a cold day in hell before we change our moral code for the sake of money. Good day, citizens. There's been a development. All hail the glorious regime and welcome to Family Jewels.
Sell out with me, oh yeah, sell out with me tonight. Give me lots of money and everything's gonna be alright. Yeah, 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 yeah. The record company is gonna make everything alright. She said, but I can't work in fast food all my life.
So Destroy, the winner of the Rat tournament, making her way out first. Hello, everyone. Hope you're all doing very well this evening. The horrible goose making its wrestling debut. Ding ding, wrestlers go. Destroyer taking no shit off the goose right off the bat. No, it's not sideburns. That's the former Dante's Inferno, now known as Sleazy B. I mean, if nothing else, sideburns isn't that much of a redhead. And the horrible goose was taking the internet by storm. Certainly has its work cut out for it. Again, Destroyer, the winner of the BOFA tournament. And in case you missed the announcement, the winner of tonight's 51-person Rumble will take on Destroyer to become our first Super Pro Wrestle Fire Pro champion. And that belt will get made after the DLC's out next week, so we can make newer belts and intros and shit.
Cover attempt by the horrible goose. Not even a one count. Misses the spear completely. The horrible goose, known for getting under people's skin. Back to the bat. Both off the ropes. Flying kick by the horrible goose, followed by the stomp. I don't know what the goose was trying there. Well, a goose can get a verbal submission with the right kind of honk. It'd be more of a honk, I guess. Kick to the face. Once again, back to the bat. The goose having none of it. Kicks the leg out of the leg. There's a scoop slam by Destroyer. Goose having none of the shit though. Hits the ropes. Knee to the back. Do geese even have knees? Power bomb. Only a two count. Not to be confused with a toucan, because this is a goose. Hits the ropes. And a Kakeshi there from the goose. Oh, Tony Nese. Okay. Destroyer once again with the headbutts. Really starting to take it to the geese now. And this has just turned into a massacre. Headbutts on the ground. Uh-oh, roly-poly. Round we go. Into the cover. And just think, if the horrible goose was to win this, would the goose get added to the title match? Well, that's how the WWF became the WWE, because Vince lost the stick match to a panda. Goose off the ropes. Kakeshi again. Oh, but there's a big fucking lariat. How much more can one goose take? There's the spinning back fist. Only a two. The never say die attitude on this goose. Tries to take down again, gets caught with the headbutts, and that's it. The referee's called this one. Destroyer. And what match rate? 87, I'll take that. As we go now to our next match. And right off the bat, the gay community taking it to the Rogies. Understand, this one comes from a Twitter beef. And already Ash hurled into the landmines on the outside. And Cass, you're getting other deathmatch, barbed wire run. And it looks like we already have blood. Double suplex there by the Rogies. Back and forth they're going. Back suplex there from Cody. Running Bulldog. Lots of groin kicks going on. Shot off the ropes and ignored. And this is with the attempt at the enziguri back and forth now between Ash and Brandy Rhodes. And it's Ash gets the better of it. Pinfall attempt by Cody. And just gets kicked off. Cover attempt, nothing doing. And of course, our senior official, senior official, right in there. It's double suplex there. Hurled into those glass tubes in the corner. Lots of back and forth here. And again, into the glass tubes. Oh, hellacious DDT there. Kicks the leg out of the leg. FTO takedown. Meanwhile, Cody with the camel clutch. Ash fights her way out. Only a two count on the cover. Dragon screw leg whip. And so far, no one gone to the else. Oh, spoke too soon. Brandy Rhodes hurled to the outside. Meanwhile, Ash with the cover on Cody. Only gets a two. Another big double suplex there. Off the ropes. Spear! And that's it! Out of nowhere. Well, that was unexpected. Match ends through stoppage. Yeah, Brandy, unsafe worker. Ding ding, rest has got. And we'd like to thank our ring crew for the expert job they've done of cleaning the ring so quickly. Back suplex there. You see a slight cut already on the head of David Arquette. Cass just looking to widen that. Big scoop slam there. Cover attempt, not even a one. Fairly cagey affair so far. Cass certainly has had the better of it. Oh, Death Valley Driver! And here they go, big strike battle! Well, thankfully he's not booked. DDT! And again! Cass just looking to shred the head of David Arquette. Let's be fair to him, he's still putting up a fight. But Cass is just vicious as hell. And it looks like both men are busted open. Misses with the second attempt at the weapon shot. Irish whip into the barbed wire. Oh, no worries, Kuzar. Oh, forearm. Barquette, not done yet. Oh, some tasty bitch slaps there. Roll up! And turnabout fair play doesn't even knock Cass off his feet though. And what the hell? He's doing the worm! Ends the worm with a punch to the junk. Two count. Yeah, we have the 1 minute warning. There's the buzzer. And both of them just back up on their feet and going for it. Big suplex there. Even Mr. Nando's busted open. And the explosion. Enough to get it done with the suplex. Sean Cash, your winner. '91? Yeah, I'd say that's fair. Fairly short, but they battered each other. Keep pressing the wrong one. Next up. Three rounds of 5 minutes. Let's go! And Punk immediately with the takedown. Nothing doing though. But there's a beautiful takedown. Punk trying to roll into a pin, perhaps force a habit. Back and forth they're going so far. Hurricane Rana! And just raining blows to the back of the head. And into a rear naked choke. Punk fights his way out. Scoop slam and a beauty. Oh, takedown there. Punk tried to roll it into a pin, but again, that doesn't happen. And what is this man doing? Into a Boston Crab. powered off. Knee to the head. Kamigoye! But he just no-sells it. And now back and forth they're going. Oh, spinning back fist. Beautifully executed. And just raining blows into the face of CM Punk. Yeah, proven MMA hold. Hello, Vera. How are you doing, friend? End of round one. Hurricane Rana out of nowhere by Punk. But beautiful takedown from Mixed Martial Panda. Shot to the gut. But catches a high kick to the face. Looking for the go to sleep. And oh my god, Punk has his first MMA win. Would you believe it? Because I certainly fucking wouldn't. So let me think. So that takes this. Because if it's Super Pro Wrestle versus everyone else, that takes the score to 2 each. Because D beat the Goose, Cass beat Arquette, Rogies beat the gay community, Punk beats Panda. So we've got two matches left and then a rumble. We're going to go to one of them now. So the story behind this one, JBI, while streaming, hit a sub goal, which resulted in him having to play all of Tony Hawk 5. And this is him getting his revenge. Let's go to ringside. I don't know who Bobby Kotick is. Well, I'm guessing you've just Googled and he's the dude that developed the game or something. I forgot to set music for them, so because otherwise he'd be coming out to Superman by Goldfinger. Ah, okay. There we go. JBI immediately with the takedown. Now Boston Crab. You would assume Tony Hawk will have at least some power. Or some center of gravity at least, having to keep his balance on those skateboards. Perform all those kick flips. JBI with a knee to the back of the head. Whips Hawk into the corner. Oh, but a slap there from Hawk. Irish whip. Oh, Hawk gets caught with a short arm clothesline. That's true, Cass, but with age comes experience. Oh my god! Oh, here we go, strike battle, who will get the better? And it's Hawk! misses with the stomp attempt. I'm hoping so, Vera. I mean, I didn't actually make Hawk. I was lucky that someone actually made Tony Hawk. So, yeah. I mean, we can but hope. Oh, takedown. Not the kind of offense we expected to see from Tony Hawk. JBI manages to get up. Oh, big lariat there. Well, I mean, Prism, I'm older than you, so. And hits the stomp off the top. Only two. Big ass chop there, hits the ropes. Covered by JVI. Big delayed suplex. But Hawk certainly not going down without a fight. The steelfish grab. Beautiful gut buster there. I don't get what, I don't get, like, skateboard trick names. Like, something like, you know, like the kickflip. I get that. You know, it makes sense, or the nose grab makes sense, but stuff like the stalefish, or, you know, there's one called Japan, going off like the games anyway. Do you think, I just wonder if like skateboarders have this like ongoing competition to see who can just come up with the most ridiculous names for moves. Like, here we go, lads, check this out, it's the throat lozenge surprise, or... Oh! Ouch! Drops Hawk right on his neck, 2.9! And the crowd coming to life for the fighting spirit of Tony Hawk, who hits the Kamigoye. I'm never making jokes in front of you again, Prism. There is panic in Detroit! And again, Hawk will not stay down. Knees to the head. Is that what we're going to be doing, you know, like, Hawk hits the collapsed flan. Atomic drop, knee, right to the unmentionables. But Hawk still fights back. Massive kick to the head. Oh, brass knuckles shot. And JBI puts Super Pro Wrestle back in the lead. I think so, 100. But Tony Hawk, make some noise for Tony Hawk, you know. Put up a hell of a fight. And we go now. To our final. Of the pre-show matches. Where it will be War Bacon. Taking on Clubber Lang. War Bacon, who has dominated pretty much everywhere he has gone. Taking on boxing legend, Clubber Lang. See, you say that Jesus was more into BMX, but I heard a hot rumour that heaven is a half pipe. He says not even thinking about the fact that, like, bikers use half pipes as well. And immediately an illegal knee out of the gate by Clubber Lang. So, there could be something to it then. How is everyone tonight anyway? And it, I guess it really depends how this one goes. Because if it goes the way of wrestling, then you'd have to give the advantage to War Bacon. But in a strike match, as we see there, it's going to be Clubber Lang that comes out with the win. Hoists him up. Oh, the not like letting off the firework. That's good to hear. I hope your dog's okay, man. Oh, big mighty slap there from War Bacon, followed by some brutal forearms. And I would say, you know, I wouldn't expect anything fancy in this one. You're just going to get big power from both men. Yes, you did, Brad. You've missed some fun matches so far. One, two, That's good to hear, mate. You know, I'm quite lucky that, like, my cats aren't really bothered their arses about fireworks. Oh, huge uppercut there. I mean, we get quite a lot of them here because I'm on Kristorfin Hill, or on the back end of Kristorfin Hill, at least. Which must be hell, because the other side of the hill's like the fucking zoo. So I don't know how some of the animals there react to them, you know? Oh, huge uppercut again! Just raining blows now. Is Clobber lying? But Warbacon gets up and goes for the pin himself. And presumably getting that count there because of the weight pressing down. Ah, that's just ridiculous, man. What an ending! Warbacon wins! Well, you know who some people are. It's, you know, they're just like, ah, Fingo, loud boom. And, you know, they get excited about that, I guess. Right, so time for the rumble. I'll load in a moment, I'm sure. So we start things off. It's Brad, who has already been eliminated by Vinnie Vogue. Who gets to take a bit of a rest at the moment. Which WWE Rumble had 51? Number 3, Spot Monkey, making his way to the ring. Off the ropes, misses. I thought that was 50. I mean actual Royal Rumbles. Because that one was a Battle Royal, wasn't it? Scoop slam by Vogue. Muerte McFly. Yeah, you did, Dawnbreaker. It has just started. We've only had one elimination so far, and number 4 has just come in. No, Vera, you've not missed yourself. We're only at number 4 so far, and only one elimination. Double drop kick from Vinnie Vogue. Oh, someone followed. Ah, but the thing's not appearing because I accidentally put the game footage over the overlay thing like a dum-dum. Whoever it was that followed, though, thank you very much. Very appreciative of that. I've fixed that now, though, so if anyone else follows, I will actually know who to thank. Back and forth. Spot Monkey gets the better of it, springs up top, and misses with the moonsault. But of course, Spot Monkey, who just flattened Jojo Lee, the referee, out comes Ovaltine Dream. Spot Monkey, always more concerned with getting his shit in than stuff that makes sense. Ah, thank you, Vera. Very, very appreciative of that. Oh, the ring's starting to fill up now. Marty McFly. Ah, right, okay. So I'm trying to keep my eye on the match. Spot Monkey. Flip him all over the place. Buck Lincoln, number 6. Wait a minute, where the hell's Buck Lincoln? Did Buck Lincoln just decide fuck this shit and leave? Is it? Okay. Out goes Vinny Vogue. 3D! LA Justice of the Thought Police out next. Right, okay. That's weird, because the last time I did a big, huge rumble, it never happened. No, you're actually named Vera Forrest, isn't it? That is indeed Spot Monkey, Jack Crimson Gaming. We're currently with Spot Monkey, Muerte McFly, LA Justice, and the Ovaltine Dream. Big lariat, long arm of the law there. Well, just explain it away, well, like someone's planted anvils above the ramp or something. Alan Rogue, number 8. Who has also vanished. Spot Monkey eliminated. Out goes the Ovaltine Dream. Calypso Sage. Number 9. Yeah, as I said, like the last time I did a huge rumble, it didn't happen once. Big Chungus, number 10. 6-9, nice. Chungus, one of our newcomers, already eliminated. Looks like he has to spend more time at Super Pro Wrestle University College. Out comes Jen Steele representing the Dark Room. Yeah, that's it. We'll blame the regime. Oh, thank you for the host, Jack Crimson. Yeah, maybe something like that. Ian Bison, also of the Dark Room, out next. Matt Denton. And just so you know, I do have random entry clicked. Here comes Aidan Fallon, one of our newcomers. Had a few appearances in our 2K stuff before everything. It's Roy! Roy, he's our boy. If he can't do it, great! Jordan Casanova, number 16. Roy is gone. And Aidan Fallon, of course, did have a few appearances with us before all that 2K business went tits up. The credit for the ramp eliminations goes to the regime. Vera Forrest, a debutante at number 17, makes her way into the ring. Big lariat on Bastard Denton there. Guy Rockford, 18. Also of the Fort Police, the ring's starting to fill up a bit. I just realised I need to fix Ellie Justice's hair. Looking very 2K-ish there. I'm not sure how I'd implement that in Fire Pro, but if I could, I would. Out goes Guy Rockford. Of everyone in the ring at the moment, the only one who was a part of that BOFA tournament, Jordan Casanova, went out in the first round to the eventual winner, Destroyer. She did the grinding armbar deal. No one gets up from the grinding armbar deal. I was originally going to make it so you could... Oh, Casey Logan, number 19. I was originally going to make it so that pinfalls and submissions would count as well, but there was a warning in the mod thing saying that that can make it bug out even more, and I didn't want to chance it. Oh, someone's busted open, I think. Or has been. You can see a bit of blood there on the mat near that Whole Snacks boutique logo. I think it may be Jen, actually. Suplex. Oh! Casey Logan getting involved there, actually saved. Meanwhile, on the other side, Bastard Denton and Muerte McFly both eliminated. See, it's one of those things I wouldn't think about until later. But Jojo Lee is just there to... just there to, you know, enforce the eliminations. The winner of this will go on to take the winner of Bofa Destroyer. We'll face them at a show next month. Details on that at a later date. Out goes Vera Forrest. Certainly a decent looking debut. Casanova Kane! Holly Rood, number 20. And still trying to eliminate LA Justice. Doesn't get it done. Vix of Sideburns Worldwide, number 21. Oh, and missed the elbow. Mulholland Driver hit on Aiden Fallon. Daz Calcio of Sideburns Worldwide, number 22. Yeah, but you endured. Out goes Vix. Someone went flying there. It's Jordan Casanova. Jen Steele is eliminated. So I think it's LA Justice that's been in there the longest at the moment. Holly Rood going up top with Daz Calcio, who comes off with a splash, aiming at completely the wrong person. Now back and forth, Aiden Fallon and Holly Rood. Oh, damn fine elbow. Now a straight combination, out goes Aiden Fallon. Back down to four in the ring at the moment. Wesley King, number 23. Nice chop there. Oh! Beautiful tag team maneuver there from Holly Rood and Wesley King. He's working on the legs. The weak point of Holly Rood is number 24, Betty Rage, makes her way out to the ring. And so far, no one has had an answer for L.A. Justice. Out goes Daz Calcio. As Tiger Vamp makes his way out to the ring. The Glasgow Bengal himself. Mandy Mayhem, number 26. Both Mandy and Holly Roode competed in both as well. Mandy went out in the first round. Holly Roode eliminated by in the quarterfinals by eventual winner, Destroyer. Lily Lestrange, number 27. I understand that's a lucky number in some other rumbles. Oh, and a huge DDT there. As the ring fills up once again. Things getting quite chaotic here. As the ring has hit maximum capacity for the moment. No more entrance until we get another elimination. Now Holly Roode, Leslie King back and forth. Damn fine elbow. Out goes Lily Lestrange. Huge brain buster there. As we await the arrival of our next competitor. Big frog splash there from King. Catches a super kick in return. King, thrown over the top, manages to roll his way back in. Not done just yet. But this, not so lucky this time. Eliminated by Elliot Justice, who has been in there for a long time now. Almost 50 minutes. Out comes Law and Order of the Thought Police. Third and final member competing in this rumble. Out goes Holly Roode and Casey. And Tiger Vamp is on fire. Three eliminations in quick succession. Oshigoroshi there from Betty Rage. Drop kick to the base of the neck. Number 29 is Rabid. I believe the final member of the Dark Room to compete. Oh wait, no, because we've still got Charlie Webb to come. Bridger Page of Cyburns Worldwide, number 30. And finally, LA Justice eliminated. I believe that was by Tiger Vamp. John's not in. Scott Murren, the Rocket Kid of Sideburns Worldwide. Yeah. Where are we? Luxembourg, probably. Eddie Violet, number 32. Scott Murren out already. Brutal fucking murder there from Betty Rage. Things really starting to speed up now. Albino, number 33. Spinning back fist there from Betty Rage. William Cesar, 34. And he's a big boy, it'll be tough to get him over the top rope. I mean, how can you eliminate him? He's so big. Charlie Webb, the final member of the Dark Round to compete in the Super Greatest or Royal Rumble Plus One. And eliminated immediately. William Cesar gone. And just so you know, you can set it so that only the frozen, not like the fall from the moves, result in eliminations, but it takes way too long if you do that. Albino eliminated. Sam King. And what a performance this is from Tiger Vamp. Oh yeah, there was no mascara, see. They started trying. And finally out goes Tiger Vamp, but what a showing from him. Daniel Fullhardy, 37. They explained it away by like, oh, you have to be thrown over or something like that. Yeah, that's what I've done, Don. Hardy with his tower breaker power bomb there. Tower hacker even. Shut up. And a double power bomb. And Rabbit, I don't know what he was trying to do to the face. Mark Anzoni, 38. As we're starting to get into the later stages. Big Chef Leo, another big man. Tony says moo. I don't, am I missing something? Galfiery, number 40. Yeah. Is things getting chaotic here? Well, you know what my memory's like, if nothing else. I can't remember shit, man. And jamming a fork into the head of Eddie Violet is rabid. He catches a super kick for his efforts. As once again we have hit capacity, reverse Rana there. What's Robin going for? Death trap! Sam King manages to hold on. And again. They're determined to get Sam King out. Out goes Rabbit. Sam King still holding on. Daniel Fullhardy is gone. And you see the blood trickling down the face of Ansoni. Sam King just refusing to be eliminated. And Sonny still holds on. JJ Strife, number 41. There's the blood now cascading from Eddie Violet. Gal Fiery eliminated. Oh, fire in the face. Jenny Usagi. And Sam King finally eliminated. Didn't manage to hold on that time. Finlay roll there from the big chef. Another elimination, Betty Rage is out. Reagan Tempest, another debut here. All the way from Wales. And immediately gets welcomed to Super Pro Wrestle the hard way. Rich Luxury, number 44. That's a good number to have. Double power bomb there. Rosie Bonbons, 45. And immediately headbutts her girlfriend. As we seem to once again have hit capacity. You think any one of these eight, if they went on to win, would be a worthy contender? Out goes Reagan Tempest. Big back suplex there. And Sonny on a roll here. Quite literally with that Finley roll. And again. Things getting chaotic here. Jumping flatliner there from Violet. Out goes Rosie Bonbons. Pretty boy Dickie Boyd, number 46. Face claw slam there from the Big Chef. This Violet's been in the longest now, I think. And he looks at taking a real beating in the course of this match. But he will not keep fighting, not stop fighting, I beg your pardon. Usagi manages to stay in. We await our next contender. Jenny Usagi eliminated. War Clown! Straight from the mind, the fresh hell that is the mind of Repelec. War Clown making his Super Pro Wrestle debut. And what a fine number to have. JJ Strife suplexed over the top. Duncan Furious, number 48. Which means we just have three entrants left. Pretty boy Dickie Boyd is out of here. The Big Chef is out of here. It could very well be one of these men who goes all the way. Eddie Violet, who has fought like a champion. Oh no! Bulldozer Sherman, number 49. Out goes Mark Anzoni. Oh my god. Rich Luxury giving that the laugh it deserved. We have just two entrants left. But right now, Eddie Violet, Duncan Furious, Rich Luxury and War Clown. War Clown has been eliminated as number 50, Sir Jasper Healington. Comes to the ring. And number 51, Dynamo Kawhi. One of these five people will go on to face Destroyer to become our first Super Pro Wrestle Person Championship Edition. And Violet, turning the ring crimson at this point. Really taking it is Kawhi to Sir Jasper Healington. Eddie Violet hits the ropes. Rolling senton onto Sir Jasper Healington. Rich Luxury holds on. They all know what's at stake. Furious eliminated. We are down to four. Eddie Violet, Rich Luxury, Sir Jasper Healington, and Dynamo Kawhi. Eddie hits the ropes. Down to three. Sir Jasper Healington, Dynamo Kawhi, and Eddie Violet are the final three. And at this point, would you bet against Eddie Violet, the beating he has taken and is still going? And not just still going, but still going strong, flying all over the place. Reverse Rana. Jasper Healington is gone. We are down to two. No signs to point at here. They both want to win. Huge knee in the corner. As Violet trying to wear down his stronger, fresher opponent. Heads up top. She holds on. Still holds on. But not that time. Eddie Violet wins. Cat's gone mental too. Because she's got her claw on board there. Well, I'm okay. What a performance. Less of that, you. So thus ends Family Jewels. So thank you everyone who came out. Always good to see you. Thank you, Vera Forrest, for the follow. My name is Adam. I run this and I run Wrestling Without Context Twitter. There's a bunch of links below where you can find out more, blah, 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 blah. I hate promoting myself. And we're going to raid the Armbar Errors Society because they're good people. But yeah, thank you for coming. Thank you for being here and see you next time. Yeah. Bye for now. Let's go!